The Indonesian president has ordered an investigation into security at football matches after one of the worst stadium disasters in history. More than 100 fans died after police tried to regain control from pitch invaders.
As thousands packed vigils in the Indonesian capital Jakarta, survivors of the football stampede relived the terror from their hospital beds. Asked how did others die? Everything. Some were trampled, fell down, and sort of got hit. Asked how did the panic begin? Tear gas. At least 125 people were killed in the stadium stampede. Hundreds more were injured. Survivors say choking tear gas sparked panic. Police insist they followed their crowd control procedures, but according to FIFA guidelines, tear gas should not be fired in stadiums.
This is a dark day for football and a tragedy beyond comprehension.
Saya menyampaikan.
The Indonesian president has ordered an investigation into security and suspended the competition.
It's a really disaster. Clear, and we're really sad about it, and our thoughts are with all the persons, all the families and the people from Indonesia.
Teenage brothers Ahmed and Muhammad Farrell left their village together. It was their first time seeing their team play. This is how they returned home. The 14 and 15-year-olds were buried side by side. Their distraught elder sister saying they were quiet and well-behaved boys who loved soccer. Ali Donaldson for 10 News First.